This is an RTV6 update, working for you.
Hello, I'm Meredith Barrick, and these are your latest headlines from the RTV6 newsroom. The welcome mat for Republican Jim Merritt officially removed by Indy Pride after it appeared that the Republican would be on the street during the annual event. This began over the weekend when political reporter Adam Wren wrote that Merritt would march in Saturday's Cadillac Barbie Indy Pride parade. That brought a quick response from the national civil rights group GLAAD. They referred to Merritt as an anti-LGBTQ activist based on his past votes as a state senator. In 2014, Merritt voted in favor of a proposal to ban same-sex marriage in the state. He later voted for the Religious Freedom Restoration Act, which critics said could have been used by businesses to discriminate against the LGBTQ community. On Sunday, Indy Pride tweeted this, saying anti-LGBTQ plus individuals and groups are not welcome at our events. Metro police are looking into a report that someone tried to abduct a girl last week near an East Side school. Police say it happened 1 week ago near Anna Brockhausen School 88. According to an IPS spokeswoman, the child was approached near a bus stop near 16th and Emerson, about 1 mile from the school. The child was getting off the bus to go home at the time. Parents immediately called police, and IPS officers have been patrolling the area ever since. So far, no arrests have been made, but IPS has warned families in the area to be extra vigilant in watching their children. Todd.
All right, it's been a nice summer-like day for us across the area with partly cloudy skies and warm temperatures. If you have plans this evening, you will notice the clouds increase a little bit, but we should remain dry. Temperatures will be in the 70s. Once we get into the overnight hours, though, before you go to sleep, make sure you have a way to find out if there's going to be any warnings issued, because there will be that potential overnight for some isolated storms to flare up, probably a little closer to daybreak than the early overnight hours. These storms will move through during the morning commute. Then we get a bit of a break through the middle half of the day, only for more storms to flare up throughout the evening hours. And especially during the evening hours, as that front comes through, there will be the potential for some severe weather. A slight risk already out for the Storm Prediction Center for tomorrow for most of the area. Wind and hail, the two main threats, and also look for potentially heavy rainfall. Some of these storms that move through could provide some localized flooding.
Todd, thank you. For more weather and stories you need to know, download the RTV6 mobile app. Thanks for joining us.